I recently bought this OBDLink LX OBD2 reader. I actually intend to use it for my Triumph Tiger 900 GT Pro motorcycle. And that will need me to install the TuneECU Android application on my phone. But for this video, join me as I unbox this OBD2 reader and install the OBDLink phone application on my Samsung Android phone, as well as demonstrate the device connecting to my car. I will also be doing a separate video where I use this OBDLink LX device and connect it to my Tiger 900 GT Pro motorcycle, and then connect the TuneECU Android application to this device in order to connect to the motorcycle. So if you're interested, subscribe and you'll get notification for when I upload that video to my YouTube channel. Let's unbox this OBDLink model LX101 OBD2 reader. Comes in a little box, shrink wrapped. The company OBDLink has several models of OBD2 readers, but I need a model that works with the TuneECU Android application to be used for my motorcycle. And there were only two models that were compatible. One is the LX model and the other is the MX Plus model. I chose this model because it's cheaper than the MX Plus model. The LX model works on Windows and Android platforms, whereas the MX Plus model adds the iPhone iOS platform, which I do not need because I have an Android phone. So this is the rear of the box. This is the top of the box. To open, just lift the lid. The box has a good presentation. So the product comes with a 3-year warranty and 180-day money-back guarantee. There's a OBDLink LX getting started guide. There is a European Union compliance statement. And here's the device. It's very small. This is the OBDLink LX device. The exact model number is LX101. That's the standard OBD2 interface. I will now download the OBDLink Android application to my phone. The name to search for is OBDLink. And the company is OBD Solutions. So this is the one I want. Click on install. It's now downloading the OBDLink application to my phone. It is installing. I will open the application. These are the terms and conditions. I'll accept them. It asks me for location permission. I'll say okay. I'll choose precise while using the application, and I will select OBDLink LX, the green device. We are now in my Mitsubishi Triton 3.2-liter diesel 4M41 truck. This is the OBD2 socket in the car. This is the OBDLink LX device. I will now insert the device into the OBD2 socket. On the device, the yellow power light lights up. The blue Bluetooth light is flashing. I will now turn the car ignition on. I will now start the engine. The Bluetooth device is connected to the port. The power LED is on and the blue light for Bluetooth is flashing. I will press this button to initiate Bluetooth pairing with my phone. Accept the pairing request. The OBDLink LX device is now paired to my phone. I now start the OBDLink application. I'll press connect. I choose OBDLink LX. Agree to the registration. Allow notifications. put my name in there and my email as part of the registration process and press register. Registration is successful. I will go and edit the vehicle information. This is all the information that I will enter for the moment. Let me see what it can diagnose. Okay, no trouble codes detected. That is correct. I have no engine warning light. Let's see what the dashboard shows. Information looks correct. Yep, the information looks okay. So there are three sets of screens on the dashboard. First set, screen 1, screen 2, and screen 3. The information looks correct. See what monitor says. I wonder what performance measures. Let me click on it. It says accelerate to begin, so I'll just push the throttle down. Right, I think this is to be used when the car is actually moving, whereas I'm stationary. Let's see what firmware update does. I will check for updates. It says the device is up to date, that is good. I like the fact that it is easy to do firmware updates. That was a simple test of this OBDLink LX101 OBD2 reader on my Mitsubishi Triton 3.2 liter diesel truck. As I said, I actually bought this for my Tiger 900 GT Pro motorcycle. For my cars, I have workshop grade G-Scan2 scanner, as well as the launch CRP429C. Check out my YouTube channel where I introduce those two workshop grade scanners. In another video, I will install this OBDLink LX to my Tiger 900 motorcycle and then integrate that with the TuneECU Android application on my phone in order to diagnose my motorcycle ECU. I hope you found this video interesting and informative. Do hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more and to help the channel grow. Thank you so much.